Hey guys, Jason here, and it is September 6th, 2011, day 16 of my college vlog. I'm going to make this one a very quick episode. I'd already recorded it, as I do all my videos that you see in this format. I tend to have already recorded them on my phone. And again, this one said it completed and it actually uploaded, but in fact, I go to YouTube and I check if any of my uploaded videos are there, and then that one is not there. I took it in my car. Like I said, I wanted somewhere different, but the sound was kind of weird because of that, so I guess it was probably for the best. But anyway, today was Tuesday, and after a long weekend, I guess, we had Labor Day yesterday, so it was an extra day off, Monday. And today was English and History. English went over pretty smoothly. I already had my homework done, as I told you in the last episode, that I was unsure if I had completed, and that was all fine and dandy. I don't have to worry about that until Thursday. As for history, there's no work to really do in that, just read from time to time. And so I read a little bit today before class because I had some time to kill, but I didn't have to do much with that. Now tomorrow is psychology, philosophy, and math. I have to read, but that's it for those two classes. And then for math, I have to do a covered box problem. And this is basically a critical thinking type of thing. I have to type up as much as I can about this. And all it really is about a piece of paper, a standard legal size piece of paper, folded. The folds are 3 inches, at least between them it is. And you'd have to see the picture, but it's basically, when you fold it, it turns into a covered box. And the questions are, what are the dimensions of the resulting covered box? And then, what would the volume be? And then, how can you determine the dimensions of the box without actually building and measuring it? In other words, if you use an algebraic expression, explain it here. And then describe how you determine the volume of the box. Explain why your method works. So that's basically width times length times height. Explain that. Explain how that works. So there you go. And then there's a part B that is, if you use 3 inches for X and it does not produce the box, or no, right, using 3 for X, which is how far it is between the folds, if it doesn't produce the largest volume possible, find the largest volume possible and the dimensions of the box it produces, justify your answer. So it really shouldn't be very hard to do it all. I'm sure it should actually go pretty fast, because, I mean, it's just a little bit of math. Jot down some answers, and then type up a very long-winded answer and explanation. So, easy enough. After that, I have speech work to do with my partner, Bernice. Tonight we are to read our chapters, chapter 21 and 22 in there, which is, I don't know, probably about 24 pages. And then email each other our ideas for this. And I haven't received an email from her as of yet, so hopefully she'll email me. I'll try to get that done tonight. I got kind of a lot going on. I still need to eat. It's almost 7. I'm killing time here. But I guess we'll see how that goes. If I don't get it done tonight, it's not a big deal. We'd like to basically have the information taken care of by Friday for speech class, go over it, discuss it, meet again before the next speech class, which is when the first presentations go, and then we go the second day, so in another 2 weeks from this Friday is when we present. So, I mean, we got plenty of time. Anyway, so I guess this is longer than I thought it was going to be, but I thought I'd just go through everything. But that's it, so that is my night's homework. Yay! Okay, guys, well, I'm gonna go get me something to eat before it gets too much later here, so I will talk to you guys later. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you in tomorrow's video, day 17.